Remain in the subcontinent for a longer time, colonialism had to remove many obstacles before it. Farsi language was one of them, a language used both by the people and the government. For centuries, it had been a vehicle to transmit thoughts and therefore was a great barrier on the way of the colonialists.
Persian was here, in the Indian subcontinent, the language of Muslims. Those coming here from different places, such as Afghanistan, would speak Persian. Even Mongols spoke Persian.
Iqbal studied in Germany too. He was much influenced by Goethe, and particularly by Nietzsche, as well as German literature. The reason is that German is the only European language talking about Eastern thoughts and ways of life. We see German translations of Hafez and Sa'di. Germany is the only Western country that speaks simultaneously about Eastern ideology.
For centuries, Farsi has been in vogue here, in India and Sindh, in the subcontinent and in Pakistan. Here for centuries, Farsi has been the language of science, literature, ethics and culture. With the fall of the Mongols in 1857 through the East India Company, the British arrived in Bombay, Madras, and other ports, little by little, and very slowly moved to the capital city, and finally, after one or two centuries, they succeeded in taking possession of New Delhi and making English an official language.
The colonialists knew very well that in order to consolidate their mastery over the occupied regions, first of all, they had to dry up local cultures' roots and substitute them with those of their own. The main obstacle there was people's language. In various ways, they changed the language. Iqbal, being quite aware of the fact, multiplied his efforts to use Farsi in his own works.
Or Farsi jo hai jab angrez aaye yahan aur 1800
when the British first came here, Persian was the language of the court.
Wo bhi Farsi hi thi kyunki court language jo thi wo Farsi thi.
The region here had close ties with Persian speaking people. Our ancestors also used Persian as their native language. For that very reason, books like Sa'di, Golestan and Bustan, along with other Iranian literary masterpieces, were used here as textbooks.
To completely annihilate the folk's culture, the British colonialists followed the way to change people's language, writing system and culture. At the time, Iqbal, as a student, knew he had to comprehend a problem quite well if he were to solve it. A great factor to enable him to know where to go was his deep knowledge.
For 50 years during the English reign of India, Farsi was the official language of the country. In Sikh's court too, they spoke in Farsi. In Maharashtra, Maheteha, and during Tipu Sultan's sovereignty, the language of communication was Farsi. The British who had come to India made English the official language, and thereafter, all learned men of every ethnic background abandoned Farsi to learn English.
Iqbal's inclination towards Germany was due to East-oriented movements there. The Germans were looking at the East. They first translated into German Sa'di and Hafez's works. Then they went to Omar Khayyam and other poets. Byzantine poems were translated. For Iqbal, Byzantine culture was Islam's soul. He was not against Arabs in general. In fact, if he showed opposition, here his opposition was to Arab despotism. However, Allama would appreciate every good literary work.
Muhammad Iqbal's academic career was spent on expanding his thoughts on Oriental philosophy. To make a connection between Eastern and Western thoughts, he took another step. He went to Europe for study.